Was hot. Hello. Somebody on here finally. I ain't gonna sit too long. Hey, whoever watching. What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? Today is Sunday, so I'm gonna do a perfume review. What are we doing on this lovely hot Sunday? Me, I'm having a drink. This is Tito's, and we got pineapple and cranberry juice today. Very refreshing, by the way. So, how's everybody doing? Comment and say hi so I know who's there. How's everyone doing? Comment and say hello so I know that you're there. I see y'all. Y'all can speak. No cat ain't got y'all tongue. So yeah, I don't want to hold everybody up too long. It's hot, as you can see, I'm burning up. I got chicken baking in the oven over there, so I'm in my kitchen, dining room area. Anyway, so we're doing a perfume review today. Hey, Drakey. And these are the perfumes that make you go, meaning these are the perfumes, like when I'm out at the store or if I'm at work or like visiting someone, they stop and they say, "Ooh, what are you wearing? What you got on? Ooh, that smells good." Those are the perfumes. I've broadened my perfume collection a whole lot, and I'm upset because unfortunately I broke one. Well, I was trying to carry them downstairs, and believe it or not, guys, I literally got my ass right online and purchased me another bottle. Actually, two back up, because this is my favorite one. My favorite perfume. And when I tell y'all I'm sick about it, I'm sick. I gotta try to figure out what I'm gonna do, what I'm gonna put it in, because I'm not about to waste this juice. That's my favorite perfume, okay? Okay, so we're gonna start with one that I've had for a long time. It's Tiffany. This is my favorite, one of my favorite old time favorites here. It's a perfume that most definitely people will stop you and ask, "What are you wearing?" It's a very, very fresh scent. It's not that expensive. Actually, I bought it when I was in Cancun. And at the time I didn't wear a lot of like perfume or actually even care to spend a lot of money on perfume, but when I was in Cancun, I decided what the hey, you know. So Tiffany, this is the bottle. It's one of my favorite perfumes. I'm gonna see what the notes are. So the top notes are mandarin orange, bergamot, lemon. Middle notes are iris, rose, black currant, and peach. The base notes are musk and patchouli. And this scent smells really, really good. It smells very classy. Hey, Kenya. Very classy. Very ladylike. This is a good summertime scent. Oh, it smells so good, y'all. So when I first spray it, I most definitely get the orange right off top. I can smell the lemon. The black currant comes through, the musk comes through, the patchouli most definitely. This is a very, very good scent. Tiffany did a really, really good job blending this. This is a good scent for date night. This is a good scent for when you're out with the homegirls, having like a nice brunch maybe. This is most definitely a good Netflix and chill scent. I mean, this makes you feel real cute and pretty, and it's light, it's not heavy. You will most definitely have a good, nice little scent trail. I think with this perfume, I think the scent probably lasts a good 4 hours to me. It's not really, really beast mode. It's just okay. Like, it's a good, after like 4 hours, it most definitely becomes like a skin scent. So that means that if someone was real close to you and they was like up under you, they can smell it. That's why I say it's a good date night scent. So, but when you first put it on and you walk into a restaurant or any, or if you walk into the room, somebody's most definitely going to ask, you know, what are you wearing? This one is Tiffany & Company, and it's an EDP. I only really mess with EDPs because they last longer. The oil concentration is better. Yeah, this smells so good. Okay, my next perfume is, I think you pronounce this Shiseido. It's called Zen. This scent right here, I wasn't even sure about. Like, when I first bought it, I was like, I don't know, but from the notes, it sound real summertime-ish. I'm into perfumes for the summertime. I'm not so much into the rules so much, because I can give a damn about the rules of, you know, wearing, what perfume do you wear in the summertime? What perfume do you wear in the winter, spring, fall? I can care less about the rules of perfume. If I smell it and if it's something that I can, you know, something that I can dig, then that's what I'm gonna go for. So this perfume I actually wore just to go to the grocery store. So I sprayed this perfume on one morning about 2 weeks ago, and I went to the grocery store to pick up, trying to find some chicken, and the lady next to me, she said, oh my God, someone smells so good. And I was like, okay, I'll take the credit for that, because I knew it was me, you know. And even the cashier, the guy, the cashier, he was like, yes, you do smell really, really good. This perfume I got from Amazon. I believe I paid $55, I believe, for this one right here. It is a summertime scent. Where did I mess up at? I'm sorry, y'all. So the notes in this one is, you got your top notes is grapefruit, pineapple, bergamot, orange, rose. Your middle notes is freesia, red apple, lotus, gardenia, lily of the valley, violet. Hey, Crystal. Violet and orris. And then your base notes is patchouli, cedar, musk, amber, incense, and pine. So this is a very good citrusy perfume. It smells like, you know, fresh, like you just got the shower, fresh. It's very citrusy. It's really, really juicy. It's not that dry type of fruit type of scent. Okay, so when I first spray it, I most definitely smell the grapefruit. Oh my God, it smells so good. I smell the grapefruit, I smell the bergamot, and I smell the orange right off top. It smells really, really good. Most perfumes come off sweet on me, like all the time. Like, I don't know why they just all come off sweet on me. I don't know, is it because I bathe with natural soap? I use natural lotions, I use natural deodorant, even my body wash, even what I use for down below, everything is natural products. So I don't know if that helps out with far as like the pH level or whatnot, but they all come out sweet. This one smells so good, and it is called Zen. You can find this on Amazon. When I get off, I'm gonna post links to these perfumes so you can find them. But this most definitely smells really, really good. It is a great summer scent. Again, it's not heavy. If you're into like citrus types of perfumes, I can kind of smell the incense to it, and I most definitely smell the patchouli. A lot of people don't like patchouli, but I find that I'm starting to like patchouli, and I'm starting to like musk. Like, a lot of my perfumes most definitely have amber, musk, and patchouli in them. I don't know. I'm not like doing it on purpose. I just find that the ones that I'm liking the best are have those scents in it. So this one is Zen. Okay, the next perfume I have is Jessica Simpson, and it's called Fancy. Ain't she cute? Now this one, I read off of Facebook, so I asked someone like their favorite perfumes, or I was on someone else's post about perfumes, and they said that they had Fancy by Jessica Simpson, and that it was like one of their top most commented perfumes. And I said, oh wow, I have to try that scent. So of course, you know, me and Amazon, we have a love relationship. And so I went to Amazon, and yes, I did find this, and I got this perfume. I think this is a 3.4 ounce bottle, and I got it for like $24. It's not expensive. It is a celebrity. Perfume. And the shit smells good. So in this perfume, you have your top notes is pear, apricot, red berries. Your middle notes are caramel, almond, gardenia, and jasmine. Your base notes are vanilla, amber, and sandalwood. And guess what? When you spray this perfume, hi Dink. When you spray this perfume, you smell every bit of every freaking note that comes out. When I tell you this shit smells sexy, okay? When you walk past, you most definitely gonna get the comments from the men. Oh my God, you can smell the caramel right off top. Oh my God, this smells so good, guys. Like, this one is called Fancy by Jessica Simpson. Okay, and it's not expensive at all. I found it for $24, a 3.4 ounce, and I'm sure you can find it even cheaper on some other perfume sites. But this, I mean, oh, I smell the caramel. I don't really too much smell the almond. I smell the vanilla. I smell the amber, and I smell the sandalwood. And those are the base notes. These are notes that you would smell like at the end after the scent has kind of dried down and you worn it for a couple of hours or so. That's when you start to smell the base notes. But of course, again, I can smell some of these things right off top. Like I most definitely can smell the caramel as soon as I sprayed it. I can smell the pear. I can smell the apricots. And I can smell the red berries. Like I can smell the fruits in here, but I smell the caramel, the vanilla. The amber. I love amber. This smells so good, guys. If you're looking for a nice, cute, but simple perfume, and you like a sweet scent, this does smell sweet. You would most definitely love this perfume. It's not so much, I wouldn't say it's a summer scent per se, but again, I don't follow the rules, you're welcome, Barbara, I don't necessarily follow the rules. I'm going to wear whatever my body and my mind and my attitude it leads me. Like I just look and I just grab a bottle and that's what I wear for the day. This one is most definitely a perfume that I cannot just walk away from and say I don't ever want to wear it again. This is an easy reach, which means is this shit smells good as hell. Like you're going to get the compliments. Your man is going to keep sniffing your neck. He's going to ask you what's that fragrance. This is most definitely one of them perfumes. When you walk past that scent trail, they're going to inquire. They're going to ask you, what are you wearing? So again, y'all, this is Fancy by Jessica Simpson. Okay, next perfume. This is by Lancôme. It is called Treasure Les Nuits. Not cheap, but not really expensive either. Treasure, I've seen these perfumes back in the day. I used to think that they were like the old lady scents. You remember when your great-grandma had the little perfumes? They had the little sample scents and everything. Treasure was always one that was in there. Well, this is like one of their flankers, meaning this is an addition to that particular perfume. And this is a perfume that's beast mode. Like when you spray this on, this shit lasts on you all day. I get at least like 8 hours when like my whole work shift when I wear this perfume right here. And when you wherever you get to your destination, wherever you're going, people are going to ask you, they're going to literally stop in their footsteps, they're gonna turn around. They're gonna give you that stanky look. Like, what are you wearing? But it's not an offensive stanky look. It's one of them looks like, damn, what are you wearing? You know what I'm saying? Like, it's one of those type of perfumes. Like, it smells so good, y'all. Like, I can't even... It's hard to explain how good this perfume smells. It smells beautiful. Like, it is a heavy scent, though. So, I wouldn't wear this, like, in hot temperatures. I would wear it probably at night, date night, or if you're going out to, like, the nightclub or somewhere, and you just want to smell like the bad bitch that you are, you know what I'm saying? This is most definitely the perfume that you're gonna put on. So, in this perfume, the top notes are pear, tangerine, bergamot. Your middle notes are strawberry, vanilla, orchid, black rose, passion fruit. Your base notes are praline, caramel, lychee, patchouli, vanilla, rose. You have coffee, you have incense, you have papyrus, and you have coumarin. I don't know what that scent is. I gotta figure out what that coumarin is. But this, listen, if you buy this perfume based off of what I say, you will not be angry, okay? The niggas is coming, okay? And the females is gonna wanna know why niggas is right behind you, okay? Okay? This smells so fucking sexy, like absolutely sexy. Like, I can smell right off the bat. I can smell the bergamot and the pears. I can smell the caramel in this. A couple of these scents, I don't know what they are now. You know, I'm still fresh, I'm still new, I'm learning some of these scents, but. It says it has incense. I can smell the incense. And it says it has licorice and coffee. I don't smell the coffee yet, but I guess it probably come at the dry down. But this is most definitely a beast mode scent. Like, when you put it on, it's going to project, and it's going to project strong. And that's why the people, when you walk past or walk into a room, they're going to stop and ask, like, what the fuck are you wearing? Like, they're going to want to know what it is that you have on. They're going to want to know. It's going to drive the men crazy, okay? The men are going to love you in this perfume. No lie. But again, I do not suggest that you wear this while it's so hot. Okay, when I get through with the video, I'm going to post the links and the names of all the perfumes. So whenever you get a moment, you can just go back to the page and just click. I'm going to make it so easy for you that all you have to do is click on the link and you're going to be right there to the perfume. Promise you. So yeah, he's going to be all over you in this. All over you in this. I don't even know how to even, like, this. It smells so good. It's even hard for me to even explain. But I was on my way to work, and when I went in, the therapist, he stopped working with his patient. He said, "What are you wearing?" Like, he had to know. Like, he literally grabbed my arm, like, "What do you have on?" He wanted to know what it was I was wearing. Like, it smells so good, y'all. So if you ever have a chance, you're looking for something different and to spice up the mood or whatever, I promise you, you get this. This is called Treasure Le Nuit. It's by Lacombe. Okay, the next perfume I have, it is another celebrity perfume, and it's by Ariana Grande. I know y'all heard of her. It's that little singer, the one that's got that little Mariah Carey thing going on with the red hair, the one that Big Sean used to go with. This is her perfume. It's called Cloud, and this perfume is a nice, cute little, it's sweet. But I can wear this in the summertime in the hot weather. It's a cute coconut type of scent. It's real cute. And it's probably like one of her top best-selling perfumes out of all the ones that she has. Who was that? I'm sorry, y'all. I was reading. Okay, Sienna. Let me inbox me. So back to this perfume here, Cloud. I was watching some reviews on YouTube and they talked about it. I don't know how I never heard of the perfume before or even knew that Ariana Grande sold or made perfumes, but it sounded very, very interesting. So of course I went to Amazon and I purchased a bottle, and it was not expensive. I believe I paid like $44 for it. And when I got it, I just was in love with the perfume. Like, I don't know how I could even explain the love that I had for this perfume. It just smelled very sensual. It smelled real light, but at the same time, sweet. And it's an easy grab for me. So yeah, when I put it on, I just was like, oh wow, this smells really, really good. So this perfume, you have, let me go and read y'all the notes. I hate when I go to certain sites and it BS's me around. Okay, so this, you have your top notes as bergamot, lavender, and pear. And then for your middle notes, you have coconut, vanilla, orchard, praline, and whipped cream. And for your base notes, you have musk, and it says something about woodsy notes. So like I said, with this perfume, most definitely can smell the coconut. The coconut is gonna smack you right in the face. It smells really, really creamy, and it smells nice and sweet, and it is one of my top perfumes where when I wear it, people actually stop and they ask me, what are you wearing? They say that it smells so good. They always ask. Also, this perfume, from what I hear and from experience, they say it's compatible to the Baccarat Rouge. If you know about the infamous Baccarat Rouge, you already know that scent, and they say that this scent leans toward, it favors that perfume, and this smells really, really good. This is also a good yes. Like, it smells like watery, like it's just like water and like coconut. Like, this smells like something like if your girl just got out the shower and you took a sniff of her lady parts down below, like this is what it should smell like, nice and clean. Like, it smells amazing. It smells, this perfume smells good, guys, like for real. $44. And it lasts all day. I wear this and I literally can smell this on me for a good like 5 to 6 hours. And then after that, it does become a skin scent, but you still can smell it. Like, you can see, it still projects. So I don't know. It just depends on what you layer things with and how much you spray. I tend to be an oversprayer. So, and then always, you know, you can always top it off later in the day, but this is it smells so good, y'all. So if y'all into that like fresh coconut watery scent, this is most definitely your go-to right here. And it's by Ariana Grande and it's called Cloud. Okay. My next scent is gonna be a 2-for-1 because this is how I wore it, okay? My very first time ever wearing it, and every time I wear it, this is how I wear it. So we have Juliet Has a Gun. And the name of this perfume, it is called Not a Perfume. The name of this perfume is called Not a Perfume, okay? So with this perfume, I think it's literally like one note, and it's a molecule. It's synthetic. It's made up. It's not something that you can purchase and buy and squeeze into a bottle. It's a made up, literally a made up scent. They made this scent. It's a molecule, it's a synthetic. So whatever the scent, whatever the ingredient is very, very expensive to buy or to incorporate into a perfume. They would have to literally charge an arm and a leg for the actual scent. So what they started doing was they started making synthetic scents to these trees or barks or whatever the hell else they use to make perfume. Let me get to it. So this perfume came out in 2010, and Okay, so it's called Ambroxan. So I believe that it's like an amber scent because you can't. They say amber costs a lot of money to make. So all it is Ambroxan, period. It's nothing else, just Ambroxan. And it's a molecule. They made it up. So when I spray this, I'm just going to spray it on my hand. Y'all, it smells so freaking good. But see, the problem to me with this perfume is, it's like when I spray it, I can smell it for like the first 5 minutes and then I can't even smell it anymore. I don't know where the fuck it goes. It's just not there anymore. But everybody else can smell it. And I don't know about y'all, but I'm the type, I love to smell, like, I love smelling like the perfumes on me. I like what I'm wearing today. I love how it smells. I like that I can still smell it. With this perfume, when I spray it, I can smell it for like the first 5 minutes and then I can't even smell the shit no more. I don't know where it goes, why I can't smell it anymore, but I can never smell it. But people around me can smell it and they always say it smells good. I can't even describe this scent. It smells like you just got out the shower. It just smells so nice and so clean. Like, I don't even know how else that I can explain the scent to y'all. Like, it's just a nice, very feminine, clean, it's light scent. It's, you're not gonna smell this scent nowhere else either. It's like its own original scent. And yes, they do put Ambroxan in a lot of other perfumes and colognes and things like that, but this is strictly just the Ambroxan by itself. There's like no other scent to this. So it's got the Ambroxan in it, but they did add like a musk to it. So it's Ambroxan and musk. Now I remember. So you can smell the musk on it. And I think that's what makes this unique. But like I said, after 5 minutes, I can't smell the shit anymore. So what I do is when I wear it, I combine it with this Oscar de la Renta Bella Rosa perfume, and this is a nice sweet rose perfume, and I will give you the notes on this. Just give me 1 second here. It is called Bella Rosa. And it's a rose scent, and you can wear this in the summertime, wintertime, whenever. Again, I don't give a shit when y'all wear it. Just wear it. If that's what you feel, do whatever makes you happy. I can't tell nobody what to wear, and oh, you shouldn't wear this or wear that. So this is the bottle. It's a nice pretty bottle. And let's see. So what does this perfume smell like? So you have it don't want to give me the ingredients. Give me 1 second. Okay, so it has pink pepper, and it has pink rose, and it's patchouli. So that's all it is, pink pepper, your patchouli, and your pink rose. And this shit smells good. I can most definitely smell the rose and patchouli in here. The pink pepper is in here, but it's like blended, like, it's blended really, really well in this perfume. It's not, you can smell it, but it's not like very prominent in here. It's like you get a hint of it. It's like they just put like a little tiny drop in there or something. But I take these two and I mix them together, right? So what you do is you would take your stronger scent, this one, and you would dash yourself in this one, and then you would take your lighter scent, this one, and then you would spray, you know, your little spray points. When these two scents integrate, oh my God, you're not going to smell yourself. I'm telling you now, you don't even smell this, but other people are going to smell you. And when you walk past, I don't care if you're just sitting down minding your business and the person sitting right next to you, they're going to ask you, what are you wearing? As a matter of fact, they're going to want to find the scent right then and there and make the purchase right then and there. They're gonna want these two. They're gonna want both of these combined together. They're gonna want it so bad. You're gonna smell so fucking good. They're gonna want it. They're gonna damn near ask you just to hand them the perfume. That's how great this combination is. So like I said, this is very nice and clean, and then you add the rose. It's very refreshing and cute and sweet. you put these two together and you just got like a mix of heaven. I don't know what else to tell you, but if you are into sweet and nice and clean and just simple and simple, and you like a little musk, these are your two. And this is Juliet Has a Gun and Oscar De La Renta Bella Rosa. Okay, my next scent is Al Hamaranin. It's Arabic. So this is called Amber Oud Gold. And so oud is a ingredient that a lot of you will find in a lot of Arabic, or like people from Dubai or somewhere, those people, those type of scents. It's like an incense, like an incense-y musk, and it can come off very, very strong. It is very prominent, but it's very distinctive. So when you have a perfume that have that has that ingredient in it, you're going to smell that ingredient. Is going to be pretty prominent. But with this one, I don't know how he did it. He mixed some amber in here, he's got some pineapple in here, he's got a couple other fruits in here, he has some musk, of course, some oud in here, and it to me smells like a fucking fruit cocktail. Listen, just give me a second to just enjoy this right now. Oh my God. Listen, and it's unisex, meaning that a man can wear this and a woman can wear this, okay? This shit smells so good, y'all. I could smell this all day, y'all. It smells so freaking good. And I found this on Amazon, and I think I only spent less than $50 for it. It just smells beautiful. I'm going to find a scent for you guys and tell you how, what's the ingredients, what's everything in here, so you would know, because I don't like, I don't want to tell y'all to get something and y'all like, you said, no, I'm going to tell you, I said it smelled good to me. And when other people smell this on you, this is another scent where they're going to stop what they're doing and they're going to ask you, what are you wearing, okay? And me, every perfume I wear for the day, I take the bottle with me because I like to show off. I like that little attention where someone says you smell good and you tell them and then you say, oh, it's this bottle here. You reach in your purse or whatnot and you show them, okay? This is one where they're going to want to know where you got it from. They're going to want to make that purchase. Hey, Davey! They're going to want to make that purchase right then and there, okay? They're going to want this perfume. They're going to want it, okay? And again, it's unisex. To me, it leans feminine. It's a very, very different scent. You're not going to smell this type of scent. It's very not the ordinary. However, there is a brand I'm not going to talk about right now that does sell a perfume that smells very, very similar to this. But if I had to take the two, I would most definitely get this, because for one, the other bottle is $300-something, and this one is under $50. You can get it right from Amazon, and it smells exactly the same. The longevity is the same. The projection is the same. The sillage is definitely the same. And I'm just going to go with this one before the other one. A lot of these perfumes now are starting to smell like some shit that you already have. Like, you can have the same 2021 perfumes come out and maybe five of them might smell different or out of the ordinary. Everything else is going to pretty much, hey cuz, it's going to smell the same. So what does this perfume smell like? So we have this perfume. It is called Amber Oud Gold. They have Amber Oud, but they have Amber Oud Gold. So if you go to Amazon, you type Amber Oud, make sure you get the gold version, okay? And I don't know what happened, but I just cut my son, did something with his phone. So now I'm going to have to wait for it to reboot itself. I know I'm getting old. Whenever you can't even have a simple Android phone, you're getting old, okay, y'all? So, let me just take a second to have the phone boost up. So, do y'all have any questions so far? What are we doing today? What are we cooking today? Are we cooking today? What are we doing today? Still drinking my Tito's, y'all. Tito's is like a great vodka, y'all. Like, it tastes so good. It's so smooth. Like, It's a nasty aftertaste. It's really, really good. It's refreshing too. Come on, phone, what the fuck? I don't know what's taking this phone so long just to power up. Yeah, eating my butt. I want my plate too. I want my plate. I'm sorry, y'all. I hate when this happened. Like, I did come prepared. So let's talk about sweating for a minute. So sweating I bought from Osha Scent. And when I was bringing all my perfumes down, this bottle busted. And this is what I'm left with. Here's all the juice from it. It is my absolute, I know it is. It's my absolute best perfume, my favorite perfume in the whole wide world. So Sweven comes from Ocha Scent. Ocha Scent is this company here. I will do a review on these pretty things here soon. But Ocha Scent makes they make their impression of the most popular perfume. So one of the most popular perfumes that's out now is Baccarat Rouge 540, and Sweven is the imposter scent of the Baccarat Rouge. Okay, let me tell you something. A small bottle of Baccarat Rouge costs $270, I think, or the regular bottle costs $300. It goes up to almost $600 for this perfume, okay? I found an equivalent to that perfume. Listen, ma'am. I found an equivalent to that perfume, and it's called Sweven from Ocha Scent. And guess how much it costs? $39.95, guys. $39.95. Listen here. That perfume smells exactly like Baccarat Rouge. Exactly like it. It's not a scent out of place. None of that. Maybe the opening is a little bit different, because with the Baccarat Rouge, I smell citrus, but with this one, I most definitely get the orange, like, right away. But it lasts the same. Like, I think this one even lasts longer. The projection is fucking ridiculous. You're not going to smell it. After a while, I don't know what's in it, because it's some synthetic scents also in this one, too. Some made-up scents in this one, too. You're not going to smell it, but everyone around you is going to smell it. They're going to smell you all the way across the freaking room somewhere. People are going to ask you, what are you wearing? Off the rip, male and female. They're going to want to know what you are wearing, okay? And again, this is the imposter version of the Baccarat Rouge. Baccarat Rouge, you can find at Neiman Marcus. You can find at Saks, Fifth Avenue. And you can get it online somewhere. It's by Mason Francis. Can't pronounce his last name, but yeah, by that man. And the perfume is very, very expensive. But why would you spend $300 on a bottle of perfume? You can get the same exact scent for $39.95, and it's going to project exactly the same. It's going to get you the same exact compliments. It's going to last exactly the same. Why even waste your time now? If you just into wanting to spend the money and say, hey, because you can't have the imposture or the fake version to something, then you go ahead and spend your $300 and all that shit. You do that. More power to you. I'm not, okay? I had Baccarat Rouge, and I can tell you firsthand witness that it's the same exact thing. These people really got, they understood the assignment, okay? They did that, okay? When they made this perfume, they did that. They knew exactly what they was doing when they made that perfume, okay? So if you want to know what is in the ingredients of Sweven, let me get to it. Again, Ocha Scent made this perfume. This is not the only perfume that they have, but it is Ocha Scent's bestseller, because right now Baccarat Rouge is like the world's bestseller right now. Yes, and they smell so good. So With Sweven, you have your top notes as jasmine, saffron, orange, marigold, ambroxan. Remember that ambroxan was that molecule, that fake scent that we talked about? And something called Evernail. And then for your base notes, you have cedarwood, ambergris, and fire balsam. Never heard of that ingredient, but more power to you. Unfortunately, I cannot describe this perfume. can't describe it. It's no description. Like, far as if you was to ask me what this perfume smell like, I can't tell you. I do not. It's very hard to describe this perfume. I've watched many reviews on YouTube even, and they don't even know how to even describe it. They just can't describe it as the shit smells good, okay? So I got this perfume. It's called Sweven. It's S-W-E-V-E-N, and it came from Ocha Scent. So if you type in Ocha Scent. If you type in Ocha Scent, and then when you go to it, it's going to, the very first perfume when you go in there, it's going to say Sweven. The very first one. That's the one you want to get, Sweven. Okay? And it's the same as that as your Baccarat Rouge. Why spend $300? Doesn't make any sense. And I'm looking at the site. This is what Baccarat Rouge looks like, okay? Do you see that price point on there? $300 just for that small bottle, okay? Why pay that when you can get this? Well, I broke it. Sorry. But I just literally bought two more. Why do that when you get the same exact for $39.95? And you're going to get the, when I say the same, I would not steer y'all wrong. I'm going to tell you what. If anybody on my friends list has the real Baccarat Rouge, any of you have the real version, I'm going to do a challenge. Purchase this Sweven from Ocha Scent. Take your Baccarat Rouge, okay? Spray this wrist with your Baccarat Rouge. Take your Sweven. Spray it on this hand. Wear that shit for the whole entire day. And come back to me and say, Coco, you're wrong. If anybody tell me I'm wrong, I'll give you $100. That's my word. My word is my bond. Okay? Okay. So with Baccarat Rouge, your scent, it's the same exact scent. They put in the same exact thing. They did not change any ingredients to try to make it anything. This to me is almost like with drugs. You have your brand name and you have your generic. Just because a drug is generic doesn't mean it's not going to work as good as the brand. Let me tell you what brand is. Brand means this is my perfume or this is my name. I own this name. If you want to make the same drug, you can go ahead and make that same drug, but you cannot use my name. So we can both make the same thing, but you're going to have to come up with your own name because I've already taken this name. You need to make up yours. So since I came out with it first, I am the brand. All y'all other little people, y'all got to make your own y'all little name. So then that's when it becomes the generic. But generic doesn't mean fake. It just means that it ain't the head BIC, if you get what I'm saying. So, again, you got your Sweven, your most complimented, and this is going to be your most complimented scent. No one smells like this, okay? People are going to literally, you could be across the room, and someone is going to smell you, and they're going to say, somebody in here smells good, and it's going to be you. If you have this on, know that it's you, and own that shit. When I'm not telling you what I think, I'm telling you what I know. That shit smells beautiful, and it's a unisex scent, but I think I like it on men, and I like it on women. And sometimes I would even mix it with this beauty right here because they say that this puts you in the mind of that perfume too. So I like to put that on, and then I might top it off with this. And pretty much for me, it just gives it that added oomph. You know what I'm saying? Something a little bit different because the perfume is becoming so popular now that a lot of people with money is starting to wear it. So I like to try to give it a little different kick to it. So that's the Baccarat Rouge. Okay. So back to this beauty right here because the phone was acting silly. I wanted to get y'all the ingredients to this one here. So give me a second and I will tell y'all about Miss Amber Oud, okay, the gold edition. This is the one I said that when you wear this, they're going to stop. They're going to ask you, what are you wearing? They're going to want to make that purchase right then and there. They're not going to want to wait. They want their shit right now, okay? They're going to most definitely want this perfume. You're going to get the compliments. They're going to stop you. They're going to say, hey, what the hell do you have on? So I'm trying to find. So they say it's an oriental perfume and it's got vanilla in it. It's got the amber. But if you just give me a second, I'm trying to find where I can get the, for some strange reason, it's not popping up where I need it to. I'm sorry, guys. I know I'm trying here. At least I can give y'all my cute little smile for right now. Try to butter y'all up a little bit with your patience. So for your top notes, you have bergamot, you have some green notes. For your middle note, you have melon, you have some sweet notes, you have your pineapple. Remember I told y'all pineapple was in there. You have your amber, and for your base note, you have your musk, your vanilla, and you have the woods. This shit to me smells like fruit cocktail mixed with your oud and the musk and the vanilla. And I swear, like, this is a one that you can most definitely appreciate. I ain't gonna steer you wrong. This shit smells good. If I could, I would. For real, it smells that good, y'all. So this is Amber Oud Gold. Make sure you get the gold version. But of course, I will have everything linked in the bottom. Okay, last but not least, we have the Miss Lovely Delana. This is Delana. And what can I say about Delana? She's everything and more. She smells like fresh pussy. Like pussy that, like, when you first wash the pussy and then, like you know how coochie, yeah, everybody's coochie has a scent, but, like, it's like this fresh scent. It's, of course, pussy don't smell. It's supposed to smell like roses and these fake artificial things that people say, you know. It's just this fresh, like, scent. And when, what up though, and when you wear this, you're going to get the compliments. They're going to stop you. They're going to lust after you. They're going to be up in the booty hole if they smell you with this. This is another perfume that's like a sweet but tart. You got your musk, you have your rose, you have this, you have your nutmeg. I don't. And this one comes off a little sweet as well on me. I am not a retailer. This is a hobby. I'm just reviewing perfume. Hopefully y'all can find your lady or your, even yourself, something that you like based off of my reviews. So spicy. Oh my God. It smells so good, y'all. Yeah, that's fine. You just inbox me. Yes, y'all. I don't know, but Delana is very, very expensive. Delana is $340 for Delana. Delana did not come to play, okay? Delana is that bitch, and she knows it, okay? When you wear Delana, the projection is fucking sickening. You're going to get the compliments. People are going to ask you, what are you wearing, okay? That $340 tag that comes along with it is most definitely, to me, worth it. I don't know. I absolutely adore this perfume. It could very easily be a signature scent for me. However, it costs too much, so I could not just wear this every day, all day. This is most definitely a perfume that you would want to keep in your collection for, like, life. And why I keep buying bottles, I don't know. But if you got the money to wear this every single day and all day, you do that, do you. But me, I'm going to wear this, like, on special occasions or when I'm trying to be that bitch. And look at this bottle. Look how cute it is. Like, can we just appreciate this bottle? Like, $340. It is glass, and it's thick glass. You have, like, this little diamond or whatnot, little rhinestone thing at the top, like this crystal at the top. It's got some embroidery here. You got the little rope. Like, she didn't come to play. She came like, I'm that bitch, and y'all gonna recognize, okay? So this perfume, it says, is sweet, it's pretty, and it's very floral. So if you're into floral scents and you're into a sweet floral scent, I would most definitely go and check this out. Of course, I wouldn't blind buy this only because it costs too much, okay? But it's most definitely like the most seductive scent that you could ever, that you would ever have in your collection. So it's got lychee, it's got rhubarb, it's got bergamot, it's got nutmeg. I can smell the nutmeg in it. I can smell the florals in here. It's a musk to it. It smells good. And then I was just reading and a question was, is the laning good? And they're like, hell yeah. Like, this is from Google. Like, it's crazy. But this house is a great house. They make other perfumes. I hope to one day be rich and can buy all of them. But for now, we're just going to stick with the Laney for now. If I ever buy any more perfumes for this house, y'all will most definitely know. But this is like another perfume that makes them go, and they're going to ask you, what are you wearing? The projection is sick. They can smell it from across the room. This perfume lasts on me for literally hours. And to me, it just seems like the more it sits on my skin, the more that my natural oils and sweat or whatnot is going through, that it just tends to like heighten up your senses, and you can, and it projects like even more. So, okay, Destiny. Okay, so this is like, it's beautiful. It's a very, very beautiful scent. So this is Delaney, and I would check her out. You can also get her, I believe you can find her at Saks, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, you can find Delaney at Saks. Let me see where you can find Delaney at. Yeah, you can find Delaney on those perfume sites, of course, and they do have like imposter scents for Delaney. I'm enjoying Delaney, so I probably wouldn't get an imposter unless Ultra Scent makes it, because Ultra Scent tends to, they know what they're doing. They says it's Delaney long lasting. The longevity is incredibly long. I can still smell scent very well into the next day, both on my skin and on my clothes. And I'm not lying, like, for $340, it's most definitely worth your money. So, those are my perfumes that make you go, that makes you ask questions. If y'all have any questions, let me know. I'm about to end this live. Ask me anything below. I will come back and answer any questions. I'm going to get the links to all these perfumes and make sure that I put them on there for you to make your purchase. If any of what I said sounds interesting to you, you know, you want a nice perfume, you're looking for something new, something different, you're into buying your lady friend something nice, one of these perfumes will most definitely be worth it. But if I was to make a suggestion just based off of you know, like a blind buy and a gift, I think this would be the winner. And this is Jessica Simpson Fancy. This is the winner right here. Yes. Good scent, and it's cheap. Look at all this juicy here. It's real juicy too. All right, y'all. Well, y'all have a great day. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.